إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله جل وعلا وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار جبريل عليه السلام جاء للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم He came to him in the hadith المشهور the famous hadith that's called hadith جبريل And he asked the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a number of questions. And from the last of these questions, he asked him, أخبرني عن الساعة, tell me about the hour. Tell me about the hour, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, ما المسؤول عنها بأعلم من السائل? He said, the one you're asking is not more knowledgeable of it than the one who was asked, being asked. He said, فأخبرني عن عمراتها, so tell me about its signs. Tell me about the signs of the hour. And what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, which be a sign of the hour, is what I want to speak about today. He said, "أن تلد الأمة ربتها." He said that, which the meaning, the slave woman will give birth to her master. That the slave woman, she will give birth to her master. The ulama of tafsir or al-hadith, in explaining this part or this speech of the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that the slave woman will give birth to her master it has a number of interpretations but of the interpretations that I like to take and I feel is the most yani munasib or appropriate for our time is that this means the woman who will take the slave woman will give birth to her master means kathratul uquq means widespread disobedience widespread undutifulness, widespread disrespect from the child to the parents. This is what I feel this means. And this is the ulama have said, this is the explanation that the slave woman will give birth to her master, meaning widespread disobedience, that the child will become the master. The child will become the one who commands. The child will become the one who prohibits. The parent will be like he or she is working for the child and the child is the boss of the home. And this is what we see today widespread. It is a musibah. It is a calamity. Not only in the ummah, rather the whole entire world. Kathratul uquq. Widespread disobedience and disrespect and changing of the roles. Who is in charge? Who is running the house? Who is the one who makes the decisions? We see today the respect level of the father, of the mother has went down so much that you would see in the street a young person yelling at their parent. And back in the day, you would never see that. Commanding their parents, take me here, take me there, give me this, I don't want to do that. Yelling and screaming and going crazy into the house so the parent can't take it, they give them what they want. This is what we see today. This was not happening even 40 years ago. This was not happening even 50 years ago. The generation before us, this was unheard of. Today in this generation, we see it almost in every household, widespread disrespect. Even the children who are better than most, even them, they do not understand the real respect level they should be given to the parents. Even the ones who are better than the others, and some of them are just terrible. Some of them are just terrible. It's just disgusting. But even the ones who are a little bit better, even them, they don't understand the true right of the parent. And today I want to speak about the right of the parent, the haq, the position, the makana, the station of the parents in the life of a Muslim from the Quran and the Sunnah. Because this mas'ala, this issue is all over the kitab. It's all over the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's all over the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if we want to be good Muslims and we want to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day of judgment, Him being pleased with us, we have to make sure we are being great and excellent to our parents and being far removed from disrespect and disobedience to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nisa, in the 36th verse, وَعَبُدُ اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this verse, He mentions and He commands us, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, which we know is the basis of the religion and is the purpose we've been created. We've been created to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many of the Muslims know that. But He says, along with His worship, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Do not associate upon us. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And be excellent to your parents. He does not only say, give your parents their rights. That's adl. That's being just. Giving your parent the right is just being just. That's what adl means. But ihsan is you're going up far and beyond to please somebody, to help somebody. This is what it means to be a muhsin. You go far and beyond doing extra. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to do with our parents. This is in Surah An-Nisa in the 36th verse. In Surah Al-Isra, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and your Lord commands, He commands, Allah azza wa jal, He commands that nothing is to be worshipped except Him, and that the parents be dealt with perfection, with excellence, with goodness, with being humble. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us in His book. This is the reality of this deen. If you think that you're worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I make my salah, I make my siyam, I give my charity, I make hajj, but you're not being excellent to your parents, I'm saying excellent, not just giving them their right, not calling them on holidays, not going to see them once in a while. I'm talking about excellent. No one should be getting better treatment from you than your parents. Nobody in this whole earth. If you're not doing that, then you have a deficiency in your religion. And know that for sure. If you are not going far and beyond to aid your parents to the point they say, MashaAllah, SubhanAllah, yet it's nothing that I can expect more from my son. It's nothing that I can expect more from my daughter. This is what it has to be in this religion. This is what the religion calls us to. Excellence, perfection, striving to be perfection with our parents, going far most that you could do, breaking your back, going further and further and further to aid them and to please them and to keep them happy with you. Na'am. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he came to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he asked him a few questions. Of those questions was, ayyul amal ahabbu ila Allah, ayyul amali ahabbu ila Allah, which deeds are the most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What are they? These are sahaba. They want to know how to earn the love of Allah. They want to know how to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, and he's from the ulama of the sahaba, from the scholars of the sahaba. He goes to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, Ya Rasulullah, what are the most beloved deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So he can do those deeds. As we should be trying to find out how to earn the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. What did the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell him firstly? He said, firstly, as-salatu ala waqtiha. Prayer on time, making the salah on time. And this salah is directly connected to the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just like the ayah states, worship Allah alone and don't associate partners with Him. You see how the Quran and the Sunnah, they come together. So in the Quran you find, worship Allah alone, don't associate partners and be excellent to your parents. And the hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was asked, what is the most beloved deeds to Allah? He says, firstly, as-salatu ala waqtiha, prayer on time. And then Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, ثُمَّ أَيْ, then what is the most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Then he said, بِرُّ الْوَالِدَيْنِ, بِرُّ الْوَالِدَيْنِ, بِرُّ الْوَالِدَيْنِ, being good to the parents, being kind to the parents, being helpful to the parents, being excellent to the parents, aiding your parents, making your parents laugh, making them happy, taking all their concern away from them. Birrul walidain. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam could have said anything in the religion. This religion is rich, full of ibadah, full of things you can do, full of ways you can earn the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet, and he is the most understanding of the religion, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the messenger of Allah. The revelation comes down to him. He could have said anything after prayer. He said after prayer, which is most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being good to your parents. If you think you're a believer, if you think you have a good religion, if you want to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and earn his pleasure, we have to all get better in this field. All of us, I feel, are falling short. And I speak about myself first. But I feel the majority of us are falling short in this field, especially the youth and this small generation, this young generation. Not only are they not helpful, not only are they not being, yani, pleasing their parents or aiding their parents, rather they are disrespecting their parents. They are speaking down to their parents. They are yelling at their parents. وَلِيَعْذُ بِاللَّهِ. You see some of them even raising their hand to their mother, raising their hand to their father. وَلِيَعْذُ بِاللَّهِ. That's going to end you in the hellfire, brother. That's going to end you in the hellfire, sister. You're trying to go up to your parents like you're somebody. Because this generation and this society makes everybody think everyone is equal. Everybody is the same. There's no makana, there's no station, there's no degrees between the people. There's no degree in this society between a man and a woman, husband and wife. No distinction here. No distinction between the children and the parents, no distinction. You can go to child and take his father to court and win. Take his mother to court and win. This is the reality. Call the cops on his parents. And we've seen this. Children calling the police on their parents. وَلِيَعْذُ بِاللَّهِ. We need to let them know that if you are Muslim, stay far away from this disrespect and disobedience. You should be being helpful to your parent. Not only if they ask you, do this for me, do that for me. You should be going to them, helping them and saying, what do you need? Searching for something. What can I do for you? How can I help you, mother? How can I help you, my father? Wallahi. Instead of doing that, we are doing the opposite. Disrespect them. Being so unhelpful that the parent does not even look at his child for any help anymore. Yani, this generation of us, we're so lazy. Our generation, so lazy, stuck with video games, stuck with the television, stuck with eating food, stuck with our friends, paying more attention to our friends than our father, the one who raised us, paying more attention to our friends than the mother, the one who raised us and bore us. This is what this generation does. No help at all, not even a good word. Come in the house, don't say nothing to his mother. Come in the house, don't say nothing to his father. Lock himself in his room and play his games and talk to his friends on the video game. He have his headset, speaking to them, enjoying himself. You don't think that hurts your father? You don't think that hurts your mother? That you pay them no mind? Just when you want something, Abby, give me this. Mommy, give me that. You delayed my lunch. You delayed my dinner. Abby, you were supposed to get me this. Abby, you were supposed to get me that. You were supposed to buy me this. You were supposed to get me this car. I did this. You're not good to me. Disrespect, disobedience, not being helpful, not being loyal, ungratefulness, just commanding and ordering. Just like the hadith says that the slave woman will give birth to her master. That we'll be commanding and the roles will change and we will be the masters and controllers of the relationship, the children. وَلِيَعْذُ بِاللَّهِ. You need to tell them what the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said. If we want to get the Jannah, if we want to get the paradise, if we want to earn the pleasure of Allah, أَلَا أُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِأَكْبَرِ الْكَبَائِرِ. Shall I not inform you of the most gravest and wicked and evil of sins? Shall I not inform you of that? The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gathered his companions. He said, shall I not inform you of the gravest of sins, the most wicked and evil of sins? Shall I not inform you of that? They said, Bala ya Rasulullah. Of course, O Messenger of Allah. What did the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? Did he say killing somebody? Did he say stealing? Did he say drinking alcohol? What did he say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He said, Al-ishraku billah wa uququl walidain. Al-ishraku billah wa uququl walidain. Shirk billah, associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and being disrespectful and disobedient and undutiful to the parents is the most gravest and wicked of sins that will earn someone in the hellfire. Earn someone in the hellfire. Just like shirk, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Allah la yaghfiru an yushraka bihi wa yaghfiru ma duna dhalika liman yasha. Allah does not forgive that he's associated partners with, and he forgives anything else under the net. He put this shirk right next to it, disrespect and disobedience to the parents. Do we have this understanding? Do we have this understanding when our mother is calling us 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 times and we don't respond? Do we have this understanding when we come home and our father tells us something and he had to repeat himself 100 times before we get up and do it? Do we have this understanding that we know that this is of the greatest and worst of sins? This is what we need to understand in this religion. This is what we have to understand. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he also informed us, this is the reason why you're unsuccessful as well. Person who has not found success in their life, you can name a reason why you have not found success and you keep running into locked doors and jammed doors and you keep running into problems and stress. That is from your unduliness and your disrespect to your parents. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has warned us. He has warned us. He said, إِثْمَانِ يُعَجِّلُهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا قَبْلَ الْآخِرَةِ الْبَغْيُ وَالْعُقُوقِ. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said two sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will hasten the punishment for these two sins in this worldly life before the akhirah. Two sins, he will hasten the punishment. Meaning if you did these sins, you'll be getting punished immediately in this life, even before you get punished in the hereafter. What are these two sins? He said, firstly, dhulm, oppression. Al-baghyu, oppression, wrongdoing, taking the rights of others. Next, he said, disobedience and disrespect and undutifulness to the parents. This will earn you to be a loser in this life. You be getting punished from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have no success in marriage. No success in your own children. No success in your own business. No success in ibadah. No success amongst the people. Nobody likes you. Everywhere you go, you're trying to do something. Everything is failing for you. Maybe that's from your disrespect and your disobedience to your parents. Maybe it was from that. Your undutifulness to them. You forgot about them. You got bigger and you forgot about them. They mean nothing to you. They're just a holiday call. When the Eid comes, I call my parents. When the Eid comes, I call. When the Eid comes, I might come by them. I might see my mother when Eid comes. Once in a while. This is why we see failure in our life. Two sins Allah will hasten in this dunya. He will hasten it. You want success in this life? Be good to your parents. And if we see between our brothers, those who have brothers and sisters, who is the one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the most barakah to? Who is the one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises up the most? Who is the one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the best family? Who is the one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the best status amongst the people? And if we found out what is the one difference between him and his siblings, I guarantee it was that he was the best to his mother and his father. This is why Allah raised him up in the dunya and gave him barakah. Gave him barakah, gave him blessings, gave him success. Na'am. This affair is not a small affair, it's not a light affair. I want to end this first khutbah with the ayah in the Quran. And why this is such a bad thing. Because as we know, kufr billah. Why is kufr so bad? Why is disbelief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so bad? It's so bad because Allah created you. He provided for you. He gives you everything. He's fashioned you. He's given you something to drink. He's given you something to eat. He's protected you from the harm of this dunya. And then you go and worship other than him. And then you disbelieve in him. Now we can understand why this is such a bad thing that will earn that person the hellfire. But if you pay attention to the parent and their excellence over you and their right over you and what they have done for you, there is nothing after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has more of a right and more excellence over you than your parents. You came out of your father as a sperm. You came out of your mother as a weak little child. We came out of our mothers as weak children that could do nothing for ourselves. If you made it to this point, where you're able to walk and you're able to provide for yourself, you'll never be able to repay these two people, ever. If you're here right now, you'll never be able to repay them, and their right over you is great, it's azim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَوَصَّيْنَ الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ. Allah commands that the parents be dealt with excellence and goodness. He commands that both of them, the father and the mother. But then he specifies the mother. He says, حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَحْنًا عَلَى وَحْنٍ. His mother carried him. Your mother carried you in her stomach 9 to 10 months, carrying you. Yani, she's stretching out. She's getting tired. She's getting sick sometimes. Her feet are getting swollen. Her beauty is leaving her. before the beauty that she had before the pregnancy that she loved so much and adorned as women love their beauty, that's leaving her in front of our eyes, her youthfulness, all for you. وَحْنًا عَلَى وَحْنًا, difficulty upon difficulty. And then the wilada itself, the difficult, yani childbearing, the child, yani when the child comes out, the delivery, how difficult. The men, you see in your wife, what she went through. The women, they know what they had to go through that time period. For you, for me, that difficulty, hours, 9, 10 hours, sometimes more than that, childbirth. Yani, the pains of childbirth, something that all these men in here, you could be outside doing construction work, you go fight in jihad, do the most difficult of work, but you men, us, we cannot do childbirth, we can't do it. How difficult it is. This is what our mother had done for us. This is why Allah singles the mother out. Then when you come out, He said, وَفِصَالَهُ فِي عَمَيْنِ, and then 2 years of you stuck to your mother's breast, every second drinking from her, every second drinking from her, every second drinking from her. She has no peace. She has no time to herself. 2 whole years, no time for herself. Even when it's time for her to get some sleep in the night, the child is all over the breast of the mother. She gets no sleep even in the nighttime. Even when the child doesn't even want to drink, he just wants comfort, he's on the breast of his mother. 2 years of that. 2 years of that. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says you must be great to them. Then He singles out His mother. A man came from Yemen with his mother on his back for Hajj. This is hadith sahih. Correct hadith, authentic hadith. A man came from Yemen to the Kaaba with his mother on his back. And he's making tawaf around the Kaaba. And he's saying, أَنَا لَهَا بَعِيرُهَا الْمُذَلَّلِ أَنَا لَهَا بَعِيرُهَا الْمُذَلَّلِ, I am her camel. I am her camel. I am my mother's camel. And he's making tawaf with his mother on his back. I am her camel. And he's shouting out, I am her camel. I am her subdued camel. I am her camel. And then he sees Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu. Radiallahu anhuma. He sees Ibn Umar. And he knows he's from the kibar of the Sahaba. And he says to him, هَلْ تَرَى إِنِّي قَدْ جَزَيْتُهَا, do you think that I have repaid my mother? Do you think I have repaid my mother because I came and I made the Hajj with her and I put her on my back? He said, La, no. وَلَا بِزَفْرَةٍ وَاحِدَةٍ, you have not repaid her back, not even for one pain that she received during childbirth. You have not repaid her back, not even for one pain she received during childbirth. وَقُولُوا قَوْلِ هَذَا أَسْتَغْفِرَ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. For the right of the parents is the greatest right after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we've explained in the first khutbah. The right of them is the greatest right after Allah. And in dealing with them, we have to understand that this is worship, it's ibadah. Dealing with your parents is not just something that you do from reciprocation. My father took care of me, I'd be good to him. My mother took care of me, I'd be good to him. This is worship in the religion of Islam. Some people may not have the best of relationship with their parents for some reason. That does not mean you don't be good to them. Even if your mother is a non-Muslim, even if your father is a non-Muslim, rather, even if they are non-Muslims who are calling you to do polytheism, calling you to commit shirk, Allah still says, live with them in goodness, be kind to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِن جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا وَصَاحِبَهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and if your two parents, they strive against you and work hard for you to disbelieve and make shirk with Allah, do not obey them in that. So if our parents, because somebody may say, my parent is not good, my parent does this, my parent is not Muslim, this, you don't have no excuse still. Allah clearly explains that. Because we see from the Sahaba that some of their parents was not Muslim. He still says, if they command you to do shirk, and in reality, if they command you to do anything from disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا, do not obey them in that. But Allah says, وَصَاحِبَهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا, but treat them and live with them in goodness and kindness and dutifulness. Still, now I ask you, because I know the majority of the people here, their parents are Muslim. If Allah says for you to be good to your parents who are kafirs, disbelievers, and they're commanding you to commit shirk, which will land you in the hellfire, and Allah still says to be good to them and help them and aid them and be kind to them, then what about you, the person who his mother and his father say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, and they make salah, and they fast, and they make hajj, and they give charity, and they from the Muslimin. What about you? What about us? If the case for the person whose parents are kuffar, who are trying to get him to do the greatest of sin, Allah still commands you to be good to them. What about the one whose parents are commanding you to make salah, and they taught you tawheed, la ilaha illallah, and they taught you good manners? What about these people? How much of a right do they have over you now? How much goodness should you be doing to them in regards to them? And there's so much more that we can go on in this field. There's so much more that I can speak about. I finish with the hadith of Rasulullah. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, رَغِبَ عَنْفُ رَغِبَ عَنْفُ رَغِبَ عَنْفُ. He said, may this person be disgraced. May this person be lowly. May this person be disgraced. They said, who ya Rasulullah? Man ya Rasulullah? Who is this person? He said, الَّذِي لَقِيَ أَوْ أَدْرَكَ وَالِدَيْهِ أَحَدَهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا وَدَّخْلَ النَّارِ. The person who should be disgraced and should be low is the one who has met one of his parents, or was around for one of his parents, or two of his parents when they have got older in age, and he still goes to the hellfire. As if the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, how can you go to the hellfire and you have an elderly parent? How? How? Meaning that the greatest and easiest of ways to earn the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and earn his Jannah is being good to your parents. So we must deal with our parents, as I mentioned, not reciprocation. Not because they did good to me, I do good to them. And if they do bad to me, I'm going to do bad to them. No, this is worship. This is the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A man killed a person. And he went to Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu. And he said, Halli tawbah. Is there any tawbah for me? He was scared for himself. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he said, Ahayyatul ummak? Is your mother alive? He said, no. Then he walks away. The companion of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he said to him, why did you ask him if his mother was alive? He said, Ana la a'lamu shay'an aqrabu ila Allah min birr al-walida. Ana la a'lamu shay'an aqrabu ila Allah min birr al-walida. He said, I do not know anything that will earn you more nearness and closeness and the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than being good to the mother. Ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qulubana ala deenik. Ya musarrib al-qulub, sarrib qulubana ala ta'atik. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربك اغفر وارحم وأنت خير الراحمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. قوموا لله قانتين وأقموا الصلاة.